Hi, Dr. Evangelos Milonas here at Kinetic Health. Today we'll be discussing the saphenous nerve, some basic anatomy, and some exercises you can perform to help do some nerve flossing or nerve gliding exercises if the nerve is entrapped anywhere along its pathway. A little bit about the anatomy. When we talk about the saphenous nerve, I'm just going to have Emmy move her leg here. It's technically just a continuation of the femoral nerve. The femoral nerve originates in the lumbar spine off of the nerve endings of L2, 3, and 4. It courses down through the pelvis. Right in this area, it runs parallel to the hip flexors, so the iliopsoas, and it comes through the femoral triangle right at this area. It courses down through the inner part of the leg and front part of the thigh. At this point here, it branches off, and from this point further down, we can discuss the origins of the saphenous nerve. So the saphenous nerve basically comes down through the adductor canal to the inner part of the knee. At this point, it actually penetrates between two muscles, the sartorius and the gracilis. A branch comes to the front part of the knee and the side here, and another one extends further down along the inside of the shin bone, the tibia, and basically at quite low at the ankle, it bifurcates, it splits into two. One nerve travels to the top and lateral side of the foot here, and the other one stays along the coursa of the bone. So clinically, it's quite significant because any entrapment of the nerve here, a little further up or even further down, can create pain, burning sensations, tingling along the inner part of the shin. It could mimic shin splints. Some people have medial knee pain. So rather than looking at the joint, which is very important, you can also start to think about ligaments, nerves, other structures in the area that might be causing the pain. So we're always thinking kinetic chain. Even though we're looking at the saphenous, we have to think what's above and what's below. Now we'll move into some exercises and we'll show you how to mobilize, how to lengthen the nerve and do some nice nerve flossing and gliding exercises on your own.
Hello, I'm Dr. Brian Abelson from Kinetic Health. I'm going to show you a couple ways to mobilize tension and glide or floss the saphenous nerve. Now, as Evangelos was saying, we've got the femoral nerve above, and basically as we get lower down below the knee here, it forms the saphenous nerve. We want to tension an area just below the knee here, but we need to get the foot in the right position so we can actually do that. So what I'll get Emmy to do here is kind of open up a little bit here and just show you. She's got her foot on the side like this up against. Don't fall over here.
Yep.
get the foot in this position. And then what we'll do is we straighten out the knee. Good. And we're going to turn the hip forward a little bit here. And then I'll get her to bend the front leg and kind of move back and forth like nice and hold it. Come back up. Good. So this is the general process for getting the saphenous aspect so we can actually get that gliding or moving through the tissue. But while we're in this position, we might as well actually get the femoral nerve portion flossing also, because we really don't know where the problem is. We could look at this area and we could say, oh, I've got this pain down here. The problem is we get entrapment farther up into the hip, and that actually would cause some of the pain down below the knee. So what we'll get her to do as she reaches forward here, I'll get her to reach over, and also get her to bring her head back slightly. Good, perfect. Take this down, like so. And again, just reach over, bend down, take the head back while keeping the foot in this position. So we're actually doing a dual job here. We're actually taking the femoral nerve and we're flossing it through the hip flexors. And at the same time, we're actually flossing the saphenous nerve. This is a great exercise. So probably do this about 5 times, let's say. Go ahead there, Amy. Reaching over, foot right to the side, foot in what we call dorsiflexion. Come back again right away. So only hold this for like 2 or 3 seconds, then we move forward again. Do it again. And excellent. And again. Good. Can you feel that stretch all the way down the leg?
Yes.
Excellent.